3.2. First sum. The first sum நம்ம கடைசியா சொல்றப்ப next we go to second third fourth லாம் முடிச்சிரலாம் find a pol second sum see the sum that second one find the polynomial equation of minimum degree with rational coefficients having 2 plus root 3 I is 1 root so is 1 root so what is the given 1 root is given that root is 2 plus root 3 I so we find a polynomial equation so நம்ம கண்டுபிடிக்க போற பாலினோமியல் அவரோட டிகிரி என்னவா இருக்குங்கறத நம்ம டிசைட் பண்ணனும் so here 1 root that is a complex root is nothing but 2 plus root 3 I then what is the another root so given 2 plus 3 root 3 I is 1 root then what is the other root 2 minus root 3 I is also another root is also another root okay so we get two roots only so if we get two roots that root is called alpha and beta so namely that the alpha root is root 3 plus I and the beta root is 2 minus root 3 I okay so alpha and beta is there so now we find out sum of the roots so sum of the roots is nothing but alpha plus beta so then we adding root 2 plus root 3 I plus 2 minus root 3 I so plus root 3 I minus root 3 I cancel we get an answer 4 so now we go to product of the roots now what is product of the roots alpha into beta so alpha into beta is something but this is a plus b and a minus b format la irukku so a square so 2 square minus root 3 I the whole square okay so therefore we get 4 minus 3 I square value so the I square value minus 1 I square value minus 1 therefore we get 4 plus 3 is equal to 7 so sum of the roots and product of the roots we find out so therefore the required polynomial the required polynomial equation is the required polynomial equation is what is the formula x square minus sum of the root x sum of the root is 4x plus product of the roots is plus 7 is equal to 0 so this is our answer that's all okay so next we go to the second third sum third sum find the polynomial equation of minimum degree with rational coefficients 2i plus 3 is a 1 root is 1 root idla or mistake panniruvinga pa ellarume takkna paathona idu or complex number so 2i plus 3 or root ah irundha 2i minus 3 or root nu solluvinga idu thappu first of all every complex number is of the form a plus ib every complex number is of the form a plus ib so ona nama confuse pandradukandi 2i ya first kuduthirukanga appo what is given so given 3 plus 2i is 1 root idha maathikanum pa ungala confuse pannadhaga kupanga paathukonga so every complex number is of the form a plus ib okay so given 3 plus 2i is 1 root then what is the other root 2 3 minus 2i so 3 minus 2i is also another root is also another root okay so there are two roots are there one is called alpha and another one is called beta so 3 plus 2i is alpha and beta equal to 3 minus 2i okay so first we find out sum of the roots so sum of the root is nothing but alpha plus beta is equal to 3 plus 3 6 next we go to the product of the roots so alpha into beta we get 3 square is 9 minus 2i the whole square is 4i square so 4 into minus 1 we get plus 4 so therefore we get an answer 13 so therefore the required polynomial equation is x square minus sum of the root x plus product of the root is 13 is equal to 0 so this is your third sum okay so next we go to fourth one the fourth sum how many roots are there in the fourth sum see this find a polynomial equation of minimum degree with rational coefficients having root 5 minus root 3 is a root so nama or polynomial find out panna porom adore one root kuduthirukanga appo illa ethana roots irukku namak theriyadu but how many irrational numbers are there are two irrational numbers vanda we get four roots okay so therefore the other roots are enna other roots root 5 plus root 3 again minus root 5 minus root 3 minus root 5 plus root 3 is it clear pa so ஸோ நமக்கு மொத்தம் டோட்டலாக ஃபோர் ரூட்ஸ் இருக்கு கையில் இருக்குது. ரூட் ஃபைவ் மைனஸ் ரூட் த்ரீ, தெர் ஆர் டூ இர்ரேஷனல் நம்பர்ஸ்னால, ஸோ தேர் ஃபோர் த அதர் ரூட்ஸ் ஆர் அகெயின் ரூட் ஃபைவ் ப்ளஸ் ரூட் த்ரீ அண்ட் ஒன் ஆல்ரெடி மைனஸ் இஸ் மைனஸ் ரூட் ஃபைவ் மைனஸ் ரூட் த்ரீ அண்ட் மைனஸ் ரூட் ஃபைவ் ப்ளஸ் ரூட் த்ரீ, அதாவது ப்ளஸ் மைனஸ் சிம்பிள் மாற்றிக்கணும் அவ்வளோதான்ப்பா. ஸோ வி கெட் ஃபோர் ரூட்ஸ், அப்போ வி ஃபார்ம் அ ஃபோர்த் டிகிரி பாலினாமியல் ஈக்குவேஷன். ஹவு டு ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் ஃபோர்த் டிகிரி பாலினாமியல் ஈக்குவேஷன்? So first of all, we take the first two roots. In the first two roots eduthu, then we can find a quadratic polynomial and take the another two roots and then we get an another quadratic polynomial. So nama kaiyila ipa two quadratic polynomials irukum, and the rendu product panna we get a corresponding fourth degree polynomial equation. So again I repeat ma'am, so take first two roots. First of all, let alpha is root 5 minus root 3 and beta is root 5 plus root 3. So first of all we take the first two roots alpha and beta, then we find out sum of the roots and the product of the roots. So what is sum of the roots? Alpha plus beta here, root 3 minus root 3 cancel, so we get 2 root 5. And what is product of the roots? Product of the root is alpha beta, we get root 5 square is 5 minus 3, we get 2. So therefore one factor of the quadratic polynomial, one factor of quadratic polynomial, ena nam rendu roots nu use pandrom and the rendu root eduthu or quadratic polynomial find out pannom, adhu or factor adukku. Quadratic polynomial is x square minus sum of the root 2 root 5 x plus product of the root 2 equal to 0. So this is one of the quadratic factor. Okay, so next we take another two roots, one is gamma and delta. What is third one? Minus root 5 minus root 3, and what is delta? Minus root 5 plus root 3. Okay, so here gamma and delta is there. So next we go to sum of the roots. What is sum of the roots? Which term is cancelled, ma'am? Minus root 3 plus root 3, so therefore we get minus 2 root 5. Then we go to the product of the roots. So product of the root is nothing but 5 square minus 3, we get again 2. Okay, so therefore another factor, so one factor of or another factor of quadratic polynomial is x square minus of minus plus 2 root 5x plus 2 is equal to 0. So this is the another quadratic polynomial. இப்ப நாலு ரூட்ஸ் இருக்கிறதுல ரெண்டு ரெண்டு ரூட்ஸ் எடுத்து we form a first quadratic polynomial. இப்ப நமக்கு we get another roots. Okay, so therefore multiply the two terms, these two quadratic factors. Okay, multiply the two quadratic factors. Hence the required polynomial. So therefore the required polynomial equation is x, first one, x square minus 2 root 5x plus 2 is one of the quadratic factor, and we find out again x square plus 2 root 5x minus 2 plus 2 is equal to 0. So multiply these two quadratic factors ma'am. இப்ப ஒண்ணு நம்ம தனித்தனியா மல்டிப்ளை பண்ண அவசியம் இல்ல. So see this here, x square and 2 is there. அதே மாதிரி இங்கே x square is plus 2. So first of all, we arrange the two terms, x square plus 2 minus 2 root 5x. Okay. Again here, again x square plus 2 plus 2 root 5x. Okay ma, is equal to 0. So this is of the form a minus b and a plus b. So this is of the formula a plus b into a minus b. Then what is the formula? A square, x square plus 2 the whole square minus b square, 2 root 5x the whole square is equal to 0. So now we simplify. What is x square the whole square? X power 4 plus 2 2s are 4 x square plus 2 2s are 4 minus here root 2 square is 4 and root 5 square is 5. So 4 5s are 20. X square is equal to 0. Then we simplify, x power 4 minus 16 x square plus 4 is equal to 0. So this is our required quadratic polynomial or polynomial equation of degree 4. Okay, So this is a quadratic polynomial equation. Puridama? So again repeat ma. So how many roots are there? So only one root is given, but these two roots are in irrational roots. Okay, irrational roots. So first irrational roots, therefore the other roots are important. Then we get the another three roots. So take the first two roots alpha and beta, and then find the product sum of the roots and product of the roots. Then we find out the quadratic polynomial. Okay, this is the one factor of the given required polynomial equation. Then we go to the another two terms. One is gamma, another one is delta. Then we have to sum of the roots we find out and product of the roots. Then we have to substitute another quadratic polynomial. So now we multiply these two quadratic polynomial. We get a corresponding fourth degree polynomial equation or quadratic polynomial. So fourth degree polynomial, fair enough, quadratic polynomial equation. Okay, so next we go to the question number one. Question number one and the last example 3.7 is a similar sampa. And the example 3.7, அது வந்து போன எக்ஸசைஸ்ல கொடுத்துருக்காங்க, பட் இந்த எக்ஸசைஸ்ல வர வேண்டிய சம் அது. க்வெஸ்சன் நம்பர் ஒன், இதே சேம் மீனிங் தான்ப்பா, நல்லா கவனிச்சுக்கோங்க. க்வெஸ்சன் நம்பர் ஒன், இது நம்ம டென்த்ல ஆல்ரெடி படிச்சது தான்ப்பா. இஃப் கே இஸ் அ ரியல், டிஸ்கஸ் த நேச்சர் ஆஃப் த ரூட்ஸ். Discuss the nature of the roots. What is the nature of the roots of the polynomial equation? 2x square plus kx plus k is equal to 0 in terms of k. In terms of k. So discuss the nature of the roots. In kekranga ma, k oda enna enna values kulla adoda roots oda nature eppadi irukum. So namak nature already theriyum. If delta is greater than 0, delta greater than 0. What does it mean by delta? Delta is nothing but the nature of the roots discriminant. So in discriminant formula, what is the discriminant formula? First of all, the discriminant, nature of the roots is nothing but discriminant delta is equal to, what is the formula? V square minus 4ac. Okay, so now the given sum, what is our a value 2, b value k, and c value again k. Okay, so a value 2, b value k, and c value k. So first of all, in discriminant we find out delta is equal to, what is our b square? Is k square minus 4 into 2 into k. Okay, so therefore we get k square minus 8k. So in k square minus 8k, we take the common number k outside. So k into k minus 8. So we get this only pa. This is our delta. But nama k ku enna enna values ku nammude nature of roots eppadi irukungiradha find out pananum appadina. So first of all, in the delta equal to 0 pannikonga. Delta ku equal to 0 potta enak enna k value kadaikum. We get k equal to 0 and k equal to 8. Modhala rendaiyum rough la pottukonga. The two factors ku equal to 0 potta we get 0 and 8. Ipo nama oru entire real line draw pannikonga. Minus infinity to plus infinity. So we get two roots, one is 0, another one is 8. So how many subinterval is there? One subinterval is minus infinity to 0, another subinterval 0 to 8, and 8 to infinity. Okay, so first of all, we take any number from this interval, that is minus infinity to 0. So we take again one negative number at k equal to minus 1. At k equal to minus 1 implies, then what is delta? Substitute k equal to minus 1 in delta, we get minus 1 into minus 9. We get plus 9. Plus 9 is greater than 0. So therefore, in this interval, the discriminant value delta is greater than 0. So next we go to the another subinterval 0 to 8 mark. So take any number 0 to 8 between 1. So at k equal to 1. At k equal to 1, then substitute in delta. And substitute in delta 1 into 1 minus 8 is minus 7. We get minus 7, which is less than 0. So here, this interval, the delta value is less than 0. So next, we go to the third subinterval, 8 to infinity. Take any number between this interval. So I take the number 9. So at k equal to 9, at k equal to 9, then what is our delta? So delta equal to 9 into 9 minus 8 ma 1. So again, we get an answer 9. 9 is greater than 0. So in this interval, again, the delta value greater than 0. அப்ப நம்ம இது என்ன எப்படி எழுத போறோம்னா, again, the two values, k equal to 0 and k equal to 8. So at k equal to 0, we get what answer? At k equal to 0, we get delta equal to 0. At k equal to 8, at delta equal to 0. அப்ப நமக்கு என்னென்ன cases வருதுங்கிறது நம்ம எழுத போறோம். Okay. So therefore, the nature of the roots. Therefore, nature of the roots. Nature of the roots. Okay. So now, first of all, if the first interval, that is called k, lies between minus infinity to minus infinity to 0 and a to infinity, the k value in the rendu interval la varappa mattum namakku enna kadaikudhu, delta greater than 0. Okay. அடுத்து இஃப் கே வேல்யூ ஜீரோவாகவும் கே வேல்யூ எயிட்டாக இருக்கிறப்ப டெல்டா வி கெட் அன் ஆன்சர் ஈக்குவல் டு ஜீரோ. இஃப் கே வேல்யூ லைஸ் பிட்வீன் ஜீரோ சாரி ஜீரோ டு எயிட், இந்த இன்டர்வெல்ல என்னுடைய டெல்டா வேல்யூ லெஸ் தேன் ஜீரோ. ஓகே, நான் ப்ரீவியஸ் ஸ்லைட் காமிக்கிறேன் பாருமா. ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஆஃப் ஆல், இந்த இன்டர்வெல் அதாவது ஃபர்ஸ்ட் இன்டர்வெல்லையும் first interval and third interval. So see this, the first interval layum third interval adavad k lies between minus infinity to 0 layum a to infinity la mattum dhaan delta greater than 0 va irukku. Okay, delta greater than 0 va eppa irukna indha rendu interval layum. Again, delta equal to 0 eppa la varudhu nu solunga, k ku 0 vum k ku na 8 um apply pandrappa delta value less than 0 eppa varudhu, 0 to 8 ku la. So idha dhaan naan combine panni eludhirken pa, puridhan paarenga. சரி, ஓகே. இப்போ வாட் இஸ் த மீனிங் ஆஃப் டெல்டா கிரேட்டர் தன் ஜீரோ? ஸோ டெல்டா கிரேட்டர் தன் ஜீரோ மீன்ஸ் இஸ் நத்திங் பட் த ரூட்ஸ் ஆர் டிஸ்டிங்க்ட் அண்ட் டிஸ்டிங்க்ட் ரியல் ரூட்ஸ். தட் இஸ் கால்டு டிஸ்டிங்க்ட் ரியல் ரூட்ஸ். டிஸ்டிங்க்ட் ரியல் ரூட்ஸ் எப்போ? இஃப் மைனஸ் இன்ஃபினிட்டி லெஸ் தேன் கே லெஸ் தேன் ஜீரோ கமா எயிட் லெஸ் தேன் கே லெஸ் தேன் இன்ஃபினிட்டி. அகெயின் ஈக்குவல் டு ஜீரோ மீன்ஸ் real and equal roots. Real and equal roots nu artham. Okay, appa if k equal to 0 and k equal to 8, again delta less than 0 is nothing but imaginary roots. Imaginary roots. So imaginary roots epa kadaikum? If 0 less than k less than 8. Okay, so this is our discuss the nature of the roots now. So again I repeat, see this. So first of all, one quadratic equation is given, 2x square plus kx plus k. We have to discuss the nature of the roots. So nature of the roots means nothing but we find out the discriminant formula. What is discriminant formula? Delta is equal to b square minus 4ac. Now comparing the given sum in original format, what is our a value 2, b value k and c value k, then we substitute in delta, we get a quadratic k into k minus 8 we get. So first of all, in roughly we go to the equal to 0 of this term, we get k equal to 0 and k equal to 8. Now we have to draw the number line minus infinity to plus infinity and put the two roots 0 and 8. So we get the two three sub intervals is there. So take any number between this first interval and then we substitute in delta, we get greater than 0. And then we go to the another number in the second sub interval, we get delta is less than 0. Again, which is similarly, we go to the third sub interval and get any one number in substituting delta, we get the delta greater than 0. In k equal to 0 and 8, we substitute k equal to 0 and 8, we get an answer delta equal to 0. So therefore, இது எல்லாத்தையும் combine பண்ணி எழுதியிருக்கோம். So therefore, the nature of the roots is nothing but the nature of the roots is nothing but the first root, அதாவது the k lies between minus infinity 0 ங்கற சப் இன்டர்வல்லையும் a to infinity ங்கற சப் இன்டர்வல்லையும் we get delta greater than 0. In at a point, same point, k க்கு 0 and k க்கு 8 போறப்ப we get delta equal to 0 and another only one sub interval க்கு we get delta less than 0. So delta greater than 0 is nothing but distinct and real roots. Delta equal to 0 now this real and equal roots, and delta less than 0 we get an imaginary roots. So this is similar sum for example 3.7. இதுவும் example 3.7 உம் similar sum for அங்கேயும் இதே தான் பட் அங்கே பிங்கிற டேர்ம் கண்டுபிடிக்கணும் ஸோ சேம் மெத்தட் ஓகே ஸோ இ டிஸ்கஸ்மா